Stratocaster, and I have mine. There's your bottom setting, one up from that. So we've got these two pickups turned on, okay? The bridge and the middle, and that gives you that, that kind of quacky sound that strats can get, and you'll really capture the sound. It's not very distorted. A little bit of edge on it, some reverb and some delay, and you'll be there. It's personally my favorite song off of Slow Hand. I saw he did a concert in Hyde Park and did this, and so I wanted to learn it. And there's a few lessons on it, but I think we'll cover some nuances that they don't, and help you play it the way Clapton does. Watching the videos that are out there live, I can see how he played it, and hopefully this will help you. So what we're going to start out doing, we're going to hammer from 5 to 7 on the 5th string, but we're going to hit the 6th string at the same time. Then we're going to come back to the 6th string and then hit the 5th string twice. Then back to 6, and then we're going to hit 5 on the 7th and 4 on the 6th. That's referencing an E chord. Okay, if you know your cage, that would be a C form of E, but we're only playing the 5th and 4th string. So what we have so far is this. So if we take that really slow, and again, he does this pretty quick, and it's real funky. You don't think of this as real funky, but it is. And then we're going to reference an A chord. We're going to hit the 2nd string at 5, 3rd string at 6, and 4th string at 7. Alright, so we have this. The very first half of that lick where we hammer on, hit the E string 6th, and then back to the 5th string at 7 twice. Back to E, and then what he does is a pull off from 5 to 4 to open, and then he does a little different lick. This is again a nuance because he's hitting an open D string. So what we do is hit 6th string, 5 to 7, hammer on, and then open 4, and then back into the lick. Consistently throughout the song. So once you get that down, take it slow. Okay. it down. So practice it slow, build up the speed to it, and you'll be able to play along. We'll go over the next part, a little interlude. For the next section, I won't be getting into the fancy names, but we'll be referencing an E again. We'll just be playing, barring across the fourth fret from the fourth through the first string, put our middle finger on the second string at 5 and the fourth string at 6. And then we play a full B chord. I've seen people teach it this way, or this. But what Clapton does is he does the full chord, the full B. And you'll see why here in a second. Okay, so we've got E to B. And then we're going to take that same form that we had here, just move it down 2 frets, and we'll be playing D to A. Repeat. Then we repeat one more time. Then when we do our DA, we're going to do this a total of 3 times. Then we go to the E to B, and we'll do a lick. So what we're doing there for the lick, all right, we're going from 2 and hammering on to 4 on the 5th string, hitting 2 on the 4th string, back to 4 on the 5th string with a pull off to 2. It's very quick. And then you're going to go to the 3rd string at 4, 2, 1, and hit an A chord. First time. Second time, you do the lick, and then an E. Now you can play the full E, just use your middle finger to rest against the 5th string so it doesn't ring. And back to the lick, A, and then what we'll do is the lick and back into our intro. Honestly, that's the whole song. Just practice the licks, build them up to speed. If you want to jam along with the lead, it's all in E major pentatonic. And you'll have a lot of fun with it. Just play your own licks with it. It's a really fun song to jam with, and a really enjoyable song. So I hope that helps everyone with little nuances in the song. Enjoy.